So good morning students, today we are going to continue with the index number. We are going to continue with the construction of index number and methods of constructing index number. Okay, we had already studied about the meaning. Now what is the meaning of index number? What is the meaning of index number? Index number means dash. Write down in the chat box. So index number is one of the most used statistical tool or statistical device in economics. Why it is important? What does it help us? How does it help us? Yeah, how does it help us? It helps us to measure changes in economic variable or group of variable over a period of time. We have different index number for different economic variables. Okay, then we got to know about the features. In feature, first important feature was a statistical, that index number is a statistical tool. Okay, then we got to know that index number are expressed in terms of percentage. Third thing we got to know that when we call it as univariate index, when we call it as univariate index, write down in the chat box. Good, Darshana. When we compute the single variable is called as, yes, Niranjan and Joel, correct. When it is a computed single variable is called as univariate index. When it is composite index, yeah, when we construct a group of variable, then it is called as composite index, right? Now, what is the suffix of base here? What is the suffix of base here? Yes, zero is the suffix of base here. It might be price, it might be quantity. Anything that we are making comparison with is called as base year, and its suffix is represented as zero. What is the suffix of present year? Yes, good. It is one. Okay, that we studied in the features. Two definition we got to know about Spiegel and Crockton-Cowden. Both of them tells us in a very, very straight manner that index number is a statistical tool. It is a device which measures or which is designed to show changes in variable or group of variable with reference to time, geographical location and other characteristics. Okay. Next thing we got to know about the terminologies, which you answered me in the chat box. Afterwards, we studied about four different types of index number. In price index number, what plays an important role? What we measure? What do we measure? Yes, we measure the general changes in the price of goods. Good. Okay, between two different time period. Now, quantity index number is also called as what? Quantity index number is also called as? Yes, good, Preeti, Niranjan, Darshana, Preeti. Yeah, it is called as volume, Pramila. Yes, it is called as volume. Now, what does this measure? Quantity index measures what? Yes, good, Niranjan. It measures Joy, Jigna, Gauri. Yeah, it measures the changes in the level of output or physical volume of production in the economy. Next thing we studied about index value index number. Now, value index number is dash of price and quantity. It is what? Very good, Preeti. It is product. It is product of price and quantity of base year and the current year. Okay. Next thing we got to know about is special purpose index number. special purpose index number are been constructed for some specific purpose. Like to calculate human development index, we have index number that has been made to calculate human development index. Okay, next thing, same with population and other things. Afterwards, we got to know about the significance of index number in economics. So index number is important for policy makers, frame economic policy. It helps us to study the trends and tendencies, because with the help of this, we get to know whether our economy is going upward, whether our economy is going downward. Okay, and we can use measures to overcome the problems and issues. Next thing, we got to know about the forecasting about the future, because we are able to study the trends, we are able to forecast, we are able to predict the future activity as well. It measures the level of prices, because of which we will be able, it is important for economy, for a government to know whether we are facing inflation or not. And even it is useful to present financial data in real terms, in actual terms. Okay. Then we were there on the steps that are involved in construction of index number. The first step is of purpose of index number. Now, we all of us know that whenever we do some research or anything, there is some motive or there is some purpose or there is some objective behind it. So there are many different types of index number used for construction with different objectives. For example, price index number is used to construct price, quantity index for quantity, consumer price index for consumer thing, wholesale price index for wholesale price. So it is very important for us to first know the objective, to know the scope. After knowing the scope and after identifying the variable, we can use the appropriate index number on those particular variable. Okay. Next thing, we got to know about the selection of base year. Selection of base year, base period is the period against which a comparisons are made. It is also called as reference year. This step is very important, because we should take the decision of base year with a proper mindset. That means it should not be too close, it should not be too far. And that particular base year should not have been gone through any natural calamities or destruction, war, or losses. Okay. Third thing, we got to know about selection of item. Now, what over here, we all of us know that it is not possible for us to study the entire economy. Can I study each and every person's mindset? Can I study each and every person, every commodity that is available in the economy? No. So it is very important to select samples. Now, on what basis sample will be selected? Out of 10 people, I'll be selecting one person's view. Okay. So I have to select the items over here. Okay, the next thing we studied yesterday. Okay, then we studied about the price quotation. Now, price quotation vary from place to place and shop to shop. So it is very important to collect data of price from a proper price reporting agency. Why we have to collect the data from price reporting agency? Because that agency will not do any kind of partiality. And if we are getting proper accurate data, then whatever our result will be there, that will be very, very clear. Okay. And whatever we are finding out, that also we will get. Next thing, moving ahead now, choice of suitable average. Now, while constructing index number, we need to take very much precaution when we are choosing down the average. Now, what in index number they are telling over here, that in index number, we can use mean as an index number. Okay. Construction of index number requires choice of suitable average. Generally, arithmetic mean is used in the construction of index number because it is simple to calculate compared to other averages. Okay, so over here arithmetic mean we are going to choose as an average to calculate because it is very simple. We will get our answer. Okay, no complications, nothing. Next, assigning proper weight. Now, what is weight? Weight refers to the relative importance of different items in the construction of an index number. Now, I already told you in value index number, we have P and we have Q, right? So, this Q is the weight. Now, weight will be of two types. One type will be of quantity weight, that is represented as small q, which we studied in second type, that is quantity index number, and P into Q. Okay, that is the product of price and quantity, which we studied in third type, that is the value weight. So there are two types of weight. One is the value weight, the second one is quantity weight. Quantity weight is denoted as Q. Value weight is the product of P into Q. Okay? Am I clear till here? Any doubt you all are having? I am talking about the assigning proper weight. It is very important to assign proper weight. Proper weight. Because while constructing the index number, weight are of two types. First one is quantity weight, that is represented as Q. Second one is value weight, that it is represented as P into Q, product of price and quantity. Since all items are not equal importance, by assigning specific weight, better result can be achieved. Now, for example, in next part, we will get to know about this particular point. Suppose I am going to calculate about the base here with the help of Pasha's index number. Over there, he has considered the base index of the current year. Okay, I'll tell you, I'll write down his formula over here now. Pasha is telling PO1 while calculating price of the current year. I will be using sigma P1 Q1 and sigma P1 POQ1. So what he is taking the common value weight, that is Q1 and Q1, that is the quantity index of the current year. Understood? This assigning weight. So assigning weight plays a very, very important role. Weight will be of two types, Q and P into Q. Can we move ahead now? If yes, then write Y in the chat box. Okay. So it is necessary to adopt some suitable measures to calculate the index number. Okay, next part is about the selection of an appropriate formula. The word itself tells us that it is very important for us to select the appropriate formula. Now, how can we select the appropriate formula? Based upon our first part, based upon a purpose. Once we decide purpose, that time we are selecting which index number we are going to use. That time only we are going to decide that which appropriate formula of index number we are going to use while calculating the index number. So the last point is that it is various formulas are there for the construction of index number. Choice of suitable formula depends upon the purpose of index number and availability of data. Am I clear till here? For example, now next formula are there, which in detail we are going to study about these formulas only. Okay, so depending upon the data, depending upon the purpose, we have to select appropriate formula. These are the 7 steps of constructing index number. Next thing, in the year 2015, Central Statistical Organization, that is the CSO, under the Ministry of Statistics, changed the base year from tabulating gross domestic product from 2004-2011-12. Now, in the year 2015, What did statistical department do? Whenever we are calculating gross domestic product, that time we will consider base year as 2011 and 12. We will collect the data related to price and quantity of the year 2011 and 12. Okay, this is the extra information which they have given in your textbook in the form of Do You Know? Okay, periodic rebasing of GDP series even 7 to 10 years is carried out to account for changing economic structure and relative price. Besides this, the base year of index of industrial production and the base year of wholesale price index has also changed from 2004-2011-12. So whenever industrial production people are going to calculate now, they will be taking base year as 2011-12. Certain base year are been fixed by the government so that there are no confusion for the people while they are selecting the... Okay, sorry for the interruption. Okay, so at the present, the process of further rebasing the base year is underway. So what they are telling over here that... base year will also, now at present this 2011 and 12 is we are considering as base year. This will again change, and when a new base year is fixed, whenever we are calculating index, we will be collecting data of that particular year only as a base year. Is the concept clear till here? If yes, then write why in the chat box. Okay. Now next, methods of constructing index number. Simple index number and weighted index number are the two methods of constructing index number. In simple index number, in your text, they have given us three different types. First one is price index number, second is quantity index number, and third one is value index number. While in weighted index number, we have two types, last first price index and partial price index. And this all five types we are going to solve now. So are you all ready with your text and notebook and pen? If yes, then write why in the chat box. Okay. First, I will tell you the meaning of simple price, simple index number. What simple index number is telling? In this method, every commodity is given equal importance. Every commodity is given equal importance. It is the easiest method. It is the easiest method of constructing index number. This method in price, we will consider price, quantity, and value means product of price and quantity. Okay. First type is price index number. First thing, you just draw this table down first. First, draw this table down. Write down the table. Don't write anything. Put the heading lesson number 6. Put the heading lesson number 6. Index numbers. Then put the heading methods of constructing index number. Then put the heading methods of constructing index number. Okay. Then write down a simple index number. Under that, write down price index number. Okay. Write the name of the chapter, main heading, subheading, and its subheading. Again, I repeat, write the name of the chapter, lesson number 6, index number, methods of constructing index number, A, simple index number, and then write under it prize index number. Okay, done. Jigna said done. If you all are done, please reply. Then draw down this table. I will repeat, no need to get distracted if you all want. Prepare three columns, okay? Commodities. First will be the commodity. Under commodity, write down A on one line, B on second line, C on third line, D on next line. If you're done, write Y. Don't write anything else. Okay. Then write down price in 2010 in rupees, base year, small p and zero. Now write down this particular part. Beside A, write down 20. Beside B, write down 60. Beside C, write down 100. Beside D, write down 40. Okay, then write down price in 2015. Current year P1, small p and 1. And 1 should also be smaller. Exactly beside that small p. Beside 20, current year A commodity price is rupees 30. Current year commodity B price is 80. Current year commodity C price is rupees 130. Current year commodity D price is rupees 60. You have done this? Okay, I got Y from Aniket, Gauri, Jigna, Darshana, Jairan, Niranjan, Pramila, Preeti, Kusum. Okay, now last one more column you add under D, that is of total. That is of total. Okay, now I will be telling you what you need to do. Okay, under it, write down the formula also. You all only tell me what you all are going to do now. Under it, write down the formula. Formula I will write down for you all. That is price index number. Price index number. You can see at the top. Capital P. नहीं, fourth column नहीं लिखना है. अभी D के नीचे एक line छोड़ो. उसके बाद ये फॉर्मूला लिखो पहले. ये फॉर्मूला लिखो. डी के बाद एक लाइन छोड़ो. उसके बाद ये फॉर्मूला लिखो. प्राइस इंडेक्स पी कैपिटल स्मॉल 01 इज इक्वल टू समेशन और सिग्मा स्मॉल P1 अपॉन समेशन और सिग्मा स्मॉल P0 इनटू 100. Okay, after writing this formula, kindly write Y. Okay, so what a formula is demanding for? A formula is demanding for summation. Summation means what? Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of summation? Sigma. Can anyone tell me the meaning of summation? summation, this sign means total. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to find total of P1 and total of P0. Okay, for P2, yes, by adding together. So what we have to add, we have to add this total and write down over here. We have to add this and write down over here. D ke niche you all have written total, right? Yes or no? Now add up base year's price. Add up base year's price. 20 plus 60 plus 100 plus 40. What is the answer? Can anyone help me out? Yeah, 220. Correct, Jigna, Niranjan, Aniket. So what you all will write? You all will write sigma under this column. Under this column, you all are going to write sigma small p 0 is equal to 220. Okay? Under base column, you all are going to write total of base year. That is sigma summation of base year. Okay? Next, if you have written, then calculate the, add up the price of different commodities of the current year. Okay? Now add 30. Okay? Jigna has already done. Joel, you too. Okay, good. Good. Okay, so everyone have done it. The answer is 300. It's correct answer. So write down sigma small p1 is equal to 300. Now what is our formula? You have written the formula. Now put the variables in the formula. First, you all are going to write, see, P, capital P, 0, 1, is equal to, what is the current year? What is the total summation of current year? What is sigma P1? What is the sigma P1? It is, yes, correct. It is 300 divided by, good, divided by 220 into 100. Okay. Now, what is the answer? Solve it and tell me the answer. Manish, answer correct hai, but point nahi hai answer mein. So values change ho jate hai. Point kidhar aayega Manish? Don't round up, Anuradha. Yes, correct Kusum, Manish. Kusum, don't round up. Yes, Darshana, correct. The correct answer is, yes, Joy, correct. Aniket. The correct answer is 136.36. So at the last, you need to write capital P 01 is equal to 136.36. Clear? This is the way. Yes, Anuradha. No, no, I didn't explain only, no, that you need to do roundup. Okay, so clear up till here? Is the price index number clear? How you need to do? In exam, they will give you this table. After doing the table, you have to read all the table, do the total of base price, do the total of current year price, then applied in the formula, that is PO1 is equal to sigma P1. your answer is there. Good students, good initiative from your side. So next we are going to solve the quantity. Over here we took the price. In this particular second type, we are going to give importance to the quantity. Quantity of the current year, quantity of the base year. Draw the table. Now put the second heading, quantity index number. Put the second heading, quantity index number. Okay, done. Then draw the table. You want me to zoom? I will zoom the screen. If you all want me to zoom the screen, I will zoom the screen. Commodities. Put the heading commodity. I will tell those who are not able to see. Under commodity, write four commodities on one line. Commodity A on one line, commodity B on another line, commodity C and D on another line. Next, QTY is the abbreviation of quantity. That is quantity dot in 2000. In the bracket, write down base year. Now, what is the base year? The suffix of base year? QO. Q stands for quantity. O stands for base year. So, quantity of commodity A is 30. Quantity of commodity in the base year was 55. Quantity of base year of commodity C is 90. Quantity of the commodity D in the base year is 35. Then write down, in the next column, write down quantity in the year 2001, that is the current year. Now we are not in 2020, we are in 2001. In bracket, write down current year and write down Q1. Small q, that stands for quantity, and 1 is the suffix of current year. Now A commodity is, current year is 45, B year commodity quantity is 70, 105, and then 60. After doing this, write down Y in the chat box. Jigna, I got your Y. Yes, Pramila, Preeti, Darshana, Joel, Anuradha. Okay, maximum students have replied me as Y. So let's move ahead. Now leave one line. Under D, write total and leave that line, and next line write the formula. Quantity index number, this formula. Capital Q, that is quantity 0, 1, small, is equal to sigma or summation or small Q1 divided by sigma small QO. Q1 quantity of the current year, total quantity of the current year, sigma QO, that is total quantity of the base year, into 100. Written the formula. Okay, now add the quantity of the base year, that is the 2O. Of all the four commodities, 30 plus 30, 55 plus 90 plus 35. What is the answer? Yes, good, Pramila and Preeti. Jigna, calculate again, please. Anuradha, good. Yes, Kusum, Pramila. The correct answer is, Jaren, calculate again. The correct answer is 200. Manish, step by step, you need to go along with me. Good, you did it first. It is 210. Yes, Jigna, correct. Yeah. Now you need to calculate quantity of the current year. Add 45, 70, 105, and 60. What is the answer? Yes, good. 280 is the answer into 100. Capital Q 01 is equal to. Put this variable in the formula. Jigna, calculate again. Anuradha, you too. What? Okay. Wait. I'll put the variables again. Q01 is equal to. Now we have to take summation Q1. What was the total of your current year? It was 280. And what was the base year quantity? Total base year quantity? It was 210 into 100. I was writing that, no, total. So I've put that thing in only in the formula. That was wrong. Achar, 9-5. Okay. Thank you, Jigna. Thank you, Jigna. Just solve this, then I will. Yes, the correct answer is 13 is extra, Pramila. Others are sleeping or what? Yes. Good. So the correct answer is Q. Oh, that's wrong. Q01 is equal to 133.3. Okay. So next lecture we are meeting up at 9:30. That time we will solve further parts. Okay.